Hello everyone, I'm Sonali. In this part, we will learn pointers. This is important topic of C programming. What is actually the pointer? Where it points? The variable which holds the address of another variable is called as a pointer. It points to a particular location in memory by storing the address of that location. When we are declaring the int I equals to 3, it tells the C compiler, reserve the space in the memory to hold integer value because data type is integer. It associates the name I with this memory location, give this name I to the memory location. Store the value 3 at this location. Okay, this is value at location. This is your location name. Associate the name I with this memory location. This is your memory location name. And this is location number. Okay, here is a address. Okay, and here is a value. We are using the some notations in this. Address of I, it returns the address of variable. When we are using the star multiplication sign or we can say the asterisk sign, we are using it as a value at address operator. It returns the value stored at particular address. Int pointer j, we are declaring the pointer like this, pointer j. Okay, j will store the address of integer value. When we are printing the pointer in bracket address of I, then at that time it will print the value of I. We will see the some example of this with the help of Turbo C. There is one more concept. It's pointer to pointer, or you can say the double pointer. The variable which holds the address of another pointer variable, okay, the variable, see, suppose this variable j, the variable which store the address of, this address of another pointer variable is known as pointer to pointer variables. Okay, in this case, this k is pointer to pointer. Because it's storing the address of this pointer. Okay. See, when we are considering only these two, then I, then pointer j. Okay. I is here and j is a pointer. Now we are trying to store this value of this pointer, that is 65522, inside the k here. Okay. The variable, this variable, which hold the address of another variable is known as pointer to pointer. Let's see some examples of this. See, here is one example. Hash include stdio.h and phonemo.h. Int I equals to 4. Value of I equals to percent %i. Okay, here we are trying to print the value of I. Okay. And then address of I equals to percent %u. Here we are using the percent %u. Why percent %u? Because it returns unsigned integer number. Because we know that value of each and every variable is only positive integer number. So it will return the unsigned integer number. Let's compile this program. Run this program. Value of I equals to 4. Address of I is 65524. Okay. You can print it on a new line for better readability. So, use here slash n. Okay. And then compile your program. And run this. So I, value of I equals to 4, address of I equals to 65524. We can make changes in same program only. We can use this pointer concept in array, in function, in strings, in each and every programs, in each and every topics of C programming language. You can use this in structures also, in files also. Okay. Here, I am declaring one variable, pointer j. Okay, j is a pointer variable. Okay, here, I am storing j equals to address of I. Okay, I have declared J is a pointer. Okay, this is my pointer. Okay, why it is pointer? Because the variable holding the address of another variable. So J is a pointer holding the address of I. Okay, so let's see. Let's print the value of J here. So printf slash n address of J. Okay, here we are printing the address of J. So percent u is necessary because we are printing the address of J. Okay, let's check it. Okay, then control F9. Address of J is here. Okay, now if you want to print the value inside the J, then print here. Print F value of J equals to percent D. We want the value, so I am writing the percent D. And then pointer J. Pointer means what? Star means what? Value at address operator. So let's see the output of this. See, your value of J equals to 4 because this star will returns you the value stored at address of J. So we can use this pointer J also. Okay. Now let's see example of double pointer. Pointer K. Okay, here I am using the example double pointer. So two pointers are necessary. Okay, K is a variable which hold the address of variable which is already a pointer. Okay, so now K holding the address of J. Okay, so let's check it. Printf address of K. First print address of K. Address of K here. Execute this program. Okay. Now address of K is 65520. Okay. Next check printf slash n value of K. Okay. K equals to percent D. I want the actual value. So I am here using pointer K. Okay. So value at address of this pointer. Then check the answer. Value of K is 4. Suppose here is a statement slash n value of K equals to do the percent u and then K. Okay, and let's check it. Now it will return this address because this K is storing the address of J as a value. Use this pointer concept in arrays, in structure, in union, in functions, in all programs. We will see this pointer in our next session also.